TBC Classic is out and we're back to 2007 nostalgia. Unless you've been doing leveling on 100 alts in retail in Outland ever since. So it's just like that, but slower. What's not in 2007 anymore is the UI design. So like I did in every goddamn expansion and classic WoW, as the self-proclaimed UI god, I'm here to show you the best add-ons and pretty much everything you will need to make your TBC experience smoother and more complete. Whether you take it slow with questing like I do, or do the same dungeon 50 times in a row, those are pretty much all the add-ons you need. I'm not 70 yet since I am mostly questing, and I have waited a bit for every add-on to be updated. If you've seen my classic vanilla video, it's pretty much similar, just with a few additions. But I've made a new pack with all the add-ons I use, just extract it to your WoW folder, classic, interface and add-ons, and be sure to update it sometimes with an app like WoW App. Alright, so let's begin. I will again talk a bit more about the 10 most essential add-ons, then a few more minor additions that I think are worth using as well. First up, we got shadowed unit frames. The unit frames are still what I consider the most important aspect of the interface. I'm still using shadowed unit frames here, customized a lot from the default frames they offer by me, to make them look similar to my LUI frames in retail. You can change them a lot. I like to keep them like this with the 3D profile, health bars that change color based on remaining health. They fade out if enemies are too far. Even added a small XP bar under the mana there. Overall, I think they are the best unit frames and most customizable ones for classic. And if you want them to look like mine, since those are the hardest to customize, you can just import my code and they will look just like mine do. That will save you a lot of time since I worked the most on those from my entire interface. It replaces everything, including party frames and drive frames too. Next up, Questy. Unless you want to do something as primitive as reading, you will probably get this add-on. Quest Helper was already there when TBC came out and I started playing WoW for the first time 10,000 years ago, so it doesn't really break the authentic classic experience if you use it. The map can get a bit clustered, but you can toggle it off and on, and it shows you available quests you can pick up, how much XP or gold they give, where to finish them, even shows you the progress of people from your group if they also have the add-on. So if you don't want to spend too much time questing and figuring them all out by yourself, you should probably get it. So you can get to 70 in a few days, then do the raids once and be done with the game already. It also gives you a nice quest tracker that you can toggle and move around, and since it's closely related, get Pawn as well, so it tells you what items from completed quests you should get that give you the biggest upgrade, or directly see what item is worth the most gold to vendor. You can also use it to just compare items from your inventory and see what's best for each spec. To see how you are best at DPS in your group because you are abusing AoE and taking aggro away from the tank and possibly dying sometimes, get Details. It's the recount of the future. I usually turn it on just during group content with a macro I have slash details toggle, and I have two frames set up, one for DPS and the other one for healing, so I know who's to blame if you wipe. Next up, you should have something for your bars, so you can faster and more easily move them and customize them. I use Domino's bars with Mask Shadow as the skin for the buttons. I like to keep them like this, three main bars on top of another, in the middle, and I have two more hidden ones on the right, that pop up only when I mouse over them. Same for the bag, micro and pet bars on the bottom right. Saves some space and looks clean. Plus, you can more easily set up key bindings, just typing slash KB in chat. Domino's also provides this nice big XP or rep bar, if you want it up to despair at how slowly you are progressing and give you anxiety to see the exact percentage you are at all the time, it's pretty good to have, although I already set up the mini XP bar in the unit frame, so it's up to you if you want it there or not. Unit frames are important, but nameplates are also very important. KUI nameplates are my favorite, I use them in retail too, makes the frames look nicer and cleaner, keeps track of dots on the target as well. You can see the cast bars of what they are casting, and you can also toggle it for friend targets too, but only outside of dungeons and raids. I think it's the cleanest nameplates you can find for classic. A really good quality of life add-on is Leatrix Plus, and the Leatrix Maps add-on. Giving you a lot of good options you can turn on that will make your life easier. Like better dress up, the big quest log from retail, bigger frames for professions, increased camera zoom, auto dismount, faster auto loot, auto sell junk from the bag and auto repair, and a lot more you can set up. Then Leatrix Map is very useful, making the map not full screen, showing you the unexplored areas, it even turns transparent if you move with it open, and you also get coordinates for your location and cursor. there's no reason why you shouldn't use it. And since we mentioned the map, a skin for the minimap is nice to have too. I found Sexy Map with a faded square skin to fit best, not really essential, but I think it fits nicer with my overall interface design. Next up, since you don't have a dungeon journal because we got store mounts instead of quality of life or graphic updates changes in Classic, get Atlas loot so you can check what items are dropping from dungeon and raid bosses. Hopefully we'll also get drop chances updated, like we already do in vanilla. And so you don't get lost, you should also install Atlas maps, so you can check the maps for all instances, their entrances and boss locations. Bags are great, aren't they? You know what's better than 5 disorganized bags? One big bag with all the slots combined. So you should get an add-on like Bagnon, so it turns your inventory into one big and easier to manage bag. Not only it's simpler to use, but also gives you more tools like a search bar or outdoor range. And if you use a data store add-on like Bagbrother, you can also check the inventory of your alts or even your bank from anywhere. Actual hacks! Auctionator makes it easier to list up actions and sell faster or buy things. Pretty useful if you are selling a lot of mats or buying a lot, it's going to be very easy to work with at the auction house with it. Plus, the best part is that it gives you the vendor prices and auction prices if you already scanned the items at the auction house before. If you don't want to use Auctionator, at least get vendor prices so you can see how much worth are the items from your bag, even if you're not talking to a vendor. And finally, deadly boss mods, very good to have so you know when the boss is doing their one mechanic, so you can stop your one button rotation and move out of the fire. We all know by now that most bosses are pretty easy, but still it's useful to have so you can keep track of what the boss is doing, also keep track of the kills and wipes you have on bosses in dungeons and raids, and the fastest time, and see a watch time for how long this goddamn quest takes. Next up, some extra add-ons that can also be nice to have, but are not as essential as the ones from above. Azeroth Autopilot is not yet working for TBC as of making this video, but you can still probably use it for 1 to 60, and it will probably be updated for Outland 2 soon, so you can turn off your brain and just go where it tells you to go. All the Things is great in retail for keeping track of mounts or transmogs. Here you can check quests completed, recipes, but even gear too. Attune keeps track of your attunement for raids. What you need to care the most about now is Karazhan. Follow the simple steps it gives and you should get ready to raid in no time. Aurora gives a nice skin to menus, chat babbles and tooltips, so they don't look so pixelated. I think it fits better in retail, but it's nice to have in Classic too, especially for the cleaner tooltips. Beast Tracker gives you an idea for your best in-slot items for each phase and every spec you have. Chatter makes the chat box nicer and cleaner, I like to just move it down there and have my chat box above it. And it also gives class color names to everyone. Classic Achievements gives you achievements in Classic, if you want to keep track of your progress and have some sort of goal to work towards. It's a pretty cool add-on to have, even though you can't get any rewards from it. But hey, there will be achievements in Wrath of the Lich King Classic, so you can be ahead of the curve. Deja Character Stats gives you more detailed and simpler to see stats about your character. It's also very customizable, so you can toggle what you want to have there or not. Gladi is like Gladius in retail for arenas, showing you better unit frames for enemies while in an arena. Gnosis cast bars is what I use for my cast bar, making it larger and easier to see, also a very customizable add-on. Immersion gives you a new experience for talking to NPCs and when reading quests, not very effective, but nice to have if you want more RPG flavor. Item rack lets you set up item sets like in retail and swap between them faster. Kill Track keeps track of how many kills you did on each mob, you can see a full list of them or toggle it on and off to display in the tooltips too. Mix Scrolling Battle Text lets you see exactly what spell did how much damage, good for retail where your dots have dots, but not that necessary here when you pretty much always know where the damage numbers are coming from. Titan Panel Classic can give you a lot of info at the top of the screen. I just like to keep up the XP tracker and the bar transparent so I know how slow I am leveling. TomTom shows you waypoints to locations, just type in chat slash way and 2 coordinates and it will give you an arrow on how to get there. No. Total RP3 is a good add-on for people in Goldshire, probably. Twitch emotes turns your chat box into Twitch chat by turning text into emotes if they are emotes. And What's Training shows you the upcoming spells you will be able to learn and at what level. That's pretty much it. Those are the best and most essential add-ons you can use for classic TVC, and I don't think you will need anything else. I hope this video was helpful and that you at least found out a few add-ons that you didn't know about that will help you out. Thanks for watching, leave a like and subscribe or I will find you and eat your bacon, and I will see you soon. Happy leveling, or endgaming, if there even is endgame after you get to 70 and one-shot all the bosses of the raids once. Bye bye!